ABC. It's Glen Kellaway, your low-end music freak. I did a video the other day, and I had a comment from KJ, my buddy, at Against the Groove. By the way, KJ has a great channel. Please subscribe, check him out. Anyway, he commented that he notices the amplifier that I have in the background of most of my videos and was asking me questions about it and said he would love to see and hear more about it. So I just thought I would do a quick video without my face that's made for radio in the video. Be a nice treat for you guys. First of all, we're listening to the Rolling Stones, High Tide and Green Grass. SACD from 2002. Sounds great. So let's start with the amp. This is made by a company called Usher. The model number is an R1.5. It is a monster tank of an amp. It weighs in at around 90 pounds. Great amp. The first 50 watts of power are Class A. I've had this amp for about 10 years and it is not disappointing me for 1 second. Great, great amp. If you're in the market for an amp, Google Usher R1.5. Great, great amplifier. So the preamp that goes with it is also Usher. It's a P106. Oh, that's not it. There we go. We gotta get lower. I'm getting old, man. It's a P106 amp, preamp. You get a look at it from back further. Above it that I was showing you is a really shit headphone amp. Now, when I say shit, I'm not swearing. It's spelled S-C-H-I-I-T. Shit, that's the name of the company. Great headphone amp. Above that, my turntable, my Rega P3 turntable. It comes with an Elise 2 cartridge. I am really seriously thinking of upgrading my cartridge, so if anybody has a Rega P3 and has some opinions on cartridges, please comment. The preamp does not have any electronics in it to keep the sound more silent, and it comes with like an intake, it's not integral, it's a separate box with all the electronics, on-off switch and all that in it. My Beatles pictures from 1964, and I recently got this. I bought it off of a for sale site called Kijiji in Canada for 20 bucks. I thought it was kind of cool. My speakers, they are Monitor Audio Series 300 Silver Series speakers. Love these speakers. I've had them for a couple months and they're just really breaking in really nice. Really nice. I'm very pleased. My albums that are in heavy rotation. Some box sets. Another candy. CDs are our favorite kind of ones I'm always listening to. I keep close. That's about it for in terms of audio equipment. Beatles stereo box. Leaf sweater hanging up because the hockey playoffs are on right now. And that's my good luck charm for the Leafs to win their series. Dylan box set. Most of my album collection, besides what I just showed you in heavy rotation. My Grateful Dead box sets. Abbey Road, 50th anniversary. Beatles singles collection. Ringo. Say hi, Ringo. Peace and love, peace and love. Little Christmas ornament, Beatles. The mono box. The white album pictures. What else have I got exciting here that's new? I've shown this before. The original flyer from Led Zeppelin at O'Keefe Center in 1969, the show I was at. I just got this today. It is a copy, small version, of a poster for Jefferson Airplane Grateful Dead at the O'Keefe Center in Toronto in 1967. They played for five nights. Bill Graham produced this show, promoted it. He didn't promote too many concerts outside of the country. I think this might have been the only one. The original poster for this sells anywhere in good condition from $5,000 and up. It's very rare. So if you happen to come across one, sell it. Pay off some debt. Buy some records. Anyway, I just got that. I'm going to frame it. I also picked up from the same person. Look, there's my puppy. Hey, Pete, say hi. You say hi? Oh, he's a good boy. He's the best dog. He's 10 years old last week. Great companion. I just got this too. Jerry Garcia poster, which I really like. And that's it. I just wanted to show you the stereo. There's a look at the whole kit and caboodle there all at once. Thanks so much for watching. Take care.